Give a Wookiee bantha meat and he'll eat for a day. Teach a Wookiee to hunt bantha and he'll eat for a lifetime. Gathering resources, including metal, food, Nova crystals and carbon, is critical to this colony's survival. I will endeavor to help Atichituk and his son Chewbacca to gain this capability. The key to colonization is self-sufficiency. We'll begin gathering resources right away. We will need to gather 200 food, 100 carbon, 50 Nova crystals, and 50 ore. To begin, click one worker. Now, to begin gathering food from the Muja fruit bush, right-click on it. Now look in the status area at the bottom of the screen. If you have a worker selected, you can see how much food the worker is holding. The worker will keep picking Muja fruit until he is carrying 10 food. Then he will carry it to the command center and return to the Muja fruit bush for more. You can learn more by moving a mouse over any of the symbols on the bottom of the screen. You can also see a miniature map of your surrounding area. To remind yourself what your objectives are, click on the Objectives button on the far right side of your screen. When your objectives change, this button will flash to let you know. To gather food faster, select all your workers and send them to work by right-clicking on a fruit bush. You can monitor your current stockpiles of food above the mini-map in the lower right corner of the screen. You can also monitor your carbon, Nova crystal, and ore stockpiles. You've gathered 50 food, which is enough to create another worker. See that large building? That's your command center. Click on your command center. Then click the Create Worker button in the lower left corner of the screen. Now watch the progress bar in the status area at the bottom of the screen. When the progress bar reaches 100%, your new worker will appear next to your command center. Another way to gather food is by shorefishing. Take your new worker and move him towards the river to the east. See those jumping fish? Select your worker and right-click on the fish. The worker will start fishing and adding to your food stockpiles. Chewbacca should be along any minute. Until then, keep your workers gathering resources. By now, you should have enough food to create another worker at your command center. That should be enough workers to get the job done. If any workers are idle, the Idle Worker button will flash below the minimap. Click on the button to jump to any workers who aren't pulling their weight. Workers aren't trained warriors like Chewbacca. They can be vulnerable to attacks from Gundarks and the like. When workers are in trouble, they can run to the command center for shelter. They can even shoot at invaders from the command center. Let's try a drill. Click on the command center. Now click on the Activate Alert Beacon button. Your workers will take shelter in the command center. Command center selected. Activate the alert beacon to continue gathering resources. Got enough food. It's time to gather carbon. Carbon is used to create duroplast, which we use for building. Click on a worker, then click on a tree. The worker will attach an extractor ring to the tree and gather carbon from it. Gundarks are approaching. Select your command center and activate the alert beacon to bring the workers inside. Send Chewbacca exploring. It's always a good idea to venture beyond the homestead to map out the territory and search for more resources. Excellent. You found some Nova crystals. These are a valuable commodity that's used as currency throughout the galaxy. You'll need 50 Nova crystals to go any further. ground ore, when processed, ore becomes durasteel, which is used to make buildings and defenses strong. You'll need 50 ore to continue. That's plenty of carbon. You should begin looking for formations of Nova crystals and ore. Gathered enough ore for now. Resources like an expert frontiersman. Are you sure you haven't colonized a planet before? He learns quickly. I am most impressed.